Okay.
I personally went patrolling last night in the West End.
To beszélni a többiek. Nem tudok.
This is an outrage. We shall chase these intruders down.
Szia, Dawson.
Good evening, Dr. Reed. How does it feel to be this evening's centerpiece? Figuratively.
Jó vagyok, köszi.
I feel perfectly fine. Do I have cause for concern?
Do not be alarmed. The Ascalon Club has a tried and tested policy for choosing its initiates.
May I ask who you are, sir?
Why would you be interested?
Well, as you seem to be the only man in the room with a beating heart, you draw quite a bit of attention yourself.
Ah, vampire senses never cease to fascinate me. They dwarf those of mere mortals. I am Aloysius Dawson, by the way.
Te ember vagy. És kutatok is?
Yes, I am. And I have been for many years. And will be until the day I die.
Haldoklós vagy.
What can you tell me about it?
It's not really my place to give you such information. I am merely a mortal member. And a dying one at that.
Ó, srádás. Mondtam, hogy haldoklik.
Are you sick?
Personally. I consider my advancing years are a sickness in itself. My body is slowly abandoning me, Dr. Reed.
Ja, tényleg. Ja, neked nincs állapotod. Tehát, hogy te nem lehetsz beteg, mivel te vagy a fő, a körzet fővezetője. Mondjam, a legfontosabb embere. Nem félsz tőlük?
Are you not afraid? You are surrounded by vampires.
Sir, it's for that very reason that I joined the club in the first place.
Nem egy titok.
Is not the nature of this club a secret shared by only a privileged few?
My dear Dr. Reed, I have spent years and a fortune precisely to gather that kind of information.
Te kérted, vagy valakit helyetted csatlakoztatott?
So you asked for membership.
I have been a member of many clubs in many countries. But I must admit, this one is my favorite.
Tehát úgy, mint amikor a Facebookon a csoportokat elvállalod. Ezt is elbevállaltad. Te mit tudsz magáról az öregről?
What can you tell me about Lord Redgrave?
I would not dare speak of our chairman without his consent.
Aha, nem mersz róla beszélni. Te a Dawson és Dawson alapítványa, ő iparnak az egyik testvére vagy, úgy gondolom. Tudsz erre mondani valamit?
Of Dawson and Dawson. The wealthiest man in England. It is a pleasure to meet such a prominent figure of London.
A withering London figurehead, to be precise.
Are you sick, Mr. Dawson? I am a doctor, you know.
My case is beyond the scope of traditional medicine. I have spent fortunes on the world's most competent doctors to arrive at that diagnostic conclusion.
I'm sorry to hear that, sir. Should I suppose that you're here in search of some form of immortality?
Absolutely not. I'm here to implement my plan to save the city I was born in, to cast out the ghastly evil that has us all on our knees.
Mit tudsz a Privenekről?
What do you know about the Guard of Priven?
I should not say this, but I admire their commitment. This is what the nation needs right now.
De ők az ellenségeink.
But they are our enemies.
They are not mine, Dr. Reed.
Jó, de nem a tiéd. Aha. És gondolom segítesz nekik, vagy nem?
Would you help them?
No. There is a time for such methods. But brute force will not be enough to fight this plague. We have to think differently.
Mit tudsz a West End-i helyzetről?
What is the situation like in this part of town?
I am sure Lord Redgrave will enlighten you more effectively than I.
A pénz nem old meg mindent.
Money cannot solve every problem. This mysterious epidemic is going to require more than money can buy.
You're right. Money is nothing unless one has the will to wield it. I have a plan, sir. A radical one that will save all that is essential in London.
What is your plan, then?
Quarantine and barricades are futile. What we need is a wall. A formidable, unscalable wall.
Oh.
To isolate the deserving from the infected masses.
Is it kitschy to message?
By doing so, you would create two separate ghettos. What if the disease gets past the wall? The results would be disastrous.
Not if we eliminate all suspected cases of infection as soon as they appear. Unnecessary, Zachary.
Are you not mistaking sacrifice for summary execution?
Why do you care? Are you not a vampire? Removed from all mortal concerns? Decisiveness is what the city needs, and it needs it now.
Okay. Tehát megölnéd azokat, akik a vírust okozták konkrétan. Na, beszéljünk az öreggel.
That went well, did it not? It is always useful to bolster the troops' morale, especially before a difficult battle.
You have the makings of a general, my lord.
I was, though very long ago. Well, not quite a general, but a proud defender of the crown.
So why did you really want to meet me?
Straight to the point again, young Ekon. All right, let's talk, you and I, Lance Sparrow.
I'm listening, my lord.
According to my spies, you have worked with Dr. Edgar Swansea on the epidemic, and your findings were quite alarming.
Ismered Edgart? Ha már ő ismer téged, te is ismered őt.
Edgar Swansea?
Not personally.
Aha.
But I've been told he has some sort of immortal fetish, and is a good friend of yours.
Az does it bother you
that I consider him my good friend?
As long as you reveal nothing of the club's inner workings, why should I forbid you engaging in conversation with the good Dr. Swansea?
Okay. Kémkedett Swansea utána?
You are spying on me.
Not personally. I really leave this
kémkedtek utána, de nem.
But once he found you, Fergal kept me informed. Until you put an end to his mission.
Jó. Ki volt igazából Fergal a te szádból ítélve?
Who was Fergal? I don't see him sipping tea with the others in the club.
Fergal Banshaw was my squire of sorts. Even before becoming that magnificent beast, he was a brute. He served me well for decades.
No, I mean, what was he? He was clearly no ordinary vampire.
No.
Vulcod.
He was a Vulcod. All muscles and instinct. Quite the rare breed. Ferociously territorial. Mortals often mistake them for werewolves.
Aha, összekeverik a vérfarkasokkal, holott hasonló termettel rendelkezik, de nem az. Azt ugye vágod, hogy én öltem meg lent a csatornában.
You do know I killed him.
Yes.
A dokkoknál. Nem a dokkoknál.
Of course not.
Szóval Whitechapel.
Your victory was quite impressive and courageous.
Mindegy, csatornában rend, a csatornában.
You earned my respect.
Jó. Tehát a szkáloknak van köze a járványhoz.
Yes, I'm convinced the recent invasion of frenzied skulls in London is directly linked to the epidemic. This is not the Spanish flu, but something else.
I would be glad to hear more of your discoveries, Dr. Reed, but for now, my main concern is the security of London's inhabitants, both mortal and immortal.
What do you mean?
Alarmed by the epidemic, the Guard of Priwen has started a war against us British vampires. To appease the situation, we must eradicate the skulls.
Hát ugye skullokkal is ugye beszélgettem, és ott közöttük van egy vezető, most hirtelen nem tudom a nevét. Hú, egy embert kihagytam. Ki volt már? Nincs itt a nevek közt, de tudható, hogy a dokkoknál. Nem, a dokkoknál volt. a szkálok rosszul, de néhány szkál békés azért. A szkálok áldozatok. Vannak azért békések.
Na. I have met peaceful and wise skulls. To exterminate them means we are no better than vampire hunters.
Skulls are hideous, shameful creatures that give all Ekon a bad name.
So, what do you want me to do?
I want you to investigate the city thoroughly. I have reason to fear there are cases of contagion in this part of town. Our absolute priority is to find and cleanse them.
And how would you like me to proceed?
By all means necessary, Dr. Reed. You are now a member of the Ascalon Club, and you have carte blanche. Interrogate the locals, follow all the leads you find, and get results.
Mm-hmm. Okay. No, elértem a negyedik szintet. Most már tudok beszélni Vénusszal. Portraits család. Találd meg West Endben a fertőzés forrásait.
Welcome to the Ascalon.
Jó, ő ennél a ragatnál ragadt. Ennél a mondatnál ragadt Arthur, tehát őt nem lehet kiúzeníteni ebből a mondatból, úgyhogy ennyit erről. Mert ő nem olyan ember, akit ki lehet nyomozni. Na. Hát akkor keressünk.
I think Lord Redgrave just suggested I was sired by an ancient vampire.
Szóval egy ősvámpira teremtöm, tehát aki a lelkeit ragadt. Jó, vizsgáljuk meg a fertőzötteket, hogy van-e, vannak-e.
I won't lie to you, Johnny. I'm not a well man.
I'm investigating the source of the epidemic in this district. Can you help me?
Infection is everywhere these days. But if you ever go to the park near that swanky house belonging to the Mulaneys.
Yes?
Mulaneys.
What about the Mulaneys? What about their house?
Not enough noise for a big family with children. Not enough movement. Closed doors. What is going on in there?
You need some rest.
Men and women.
Charlotte, tudsz valamit?
Good evening, Miss Ashbury.
And good evening to you, Dr. Reed.
I'm investigating the source of the epidemic in this district. Have you noticed anything unusual recently?
A few days ago, I spotted a strange house while campaigning for women's suffrage. Awful smell. No answer when I knocked.
Where is it?
It's the Mulaneys. A nice family. Who live in a big house near the park in the eastern part of this neighborhood.
Goodbye, Charlotte. Give my best regards.
She's been quite...
Ah, újabb alak. A kalapos.
Good evening, sir. Please forgive me for disturbing you. I'm a doctor.
I never judge a man by his title, but by his
attitude. Calhoun.
And you are not disturbing me at all. I am Calhoun Russell, welcome you.
Well, I must admit, it's good to receive a warm welcome for once. I'm Doctor. I'm Jonathan Reed.
Welcome, Dr. Reed. Welcome to my humble shop.
Okay. Ő az egyik boltos.
I may have a look at your goods, Mr. Russell.
Mm-hmm. Jó, drága. Jó, beszélgessünk.
Good.
What can you tell me about this place?
I recently found the best steak and kidney pie in the city. I'd be glad to share the address if you want.
Veshe Pite.
Finding a good restaurant. Is that really all that interests you?
Oh, I have many passions, but nothing brings me ecstasy like subtle and exquisite flavors from my teeth to my belly.
Szereti a jó éttermeket és az ízletes falatokat. Ha, szóval szereti a hasát. Oké, ezt jó tudni. Nekem másmilyen az ízlésem. Mi mindig ott vagyok fennakadva, hogy vese, pite! Mi nem inkább Wellington bélszín? Az inkább az... angolos. Aha, újabb mellé küldi. Jó, nem érdekel.
How is the situation in this part of town?
Life is good and peaceful. We're lucky to live in such an era of progress and wonders.
Are you not concerned about the epidemic?
Oh, I'm sure the authorities would take the appropriate measure if the danger were that high.
Ne legyél az egy naív.
You cannot expect the newspapers to expose the truth while the war is still raging. I can assure you that the situation here is desperate.
Well, that's news then. But I can't believe that things are that bad. Are you sure you're not exaggerating a bit? For the thrill of it?
Oh. Nem gondolta át a járvány komolyságát és veszélyességét. De azt hiszem, hogy gyerekjáték az egész.
Is it not a little too late to be trading?
On the contrary, it is the perfect hour. Believe me, my friend, it is always at night that you meet the most fascinating characters.
But what about the epidemic? The bombs and raids? And all the random violence?
Please, sir, this is London, England. We will prevail. And if a bomb must fall on my shop, then I'll be there to hear it falling.
So you prefer to work at night?
Oh, I also enjoy a sunny day like everybody else. But the night always has a certain je ne sais quoi of its own.
Van családod?
Do you have any family nearby?
Not since my parents died.
Oh, second.
I'm London's lone gourmet.
Really? But you seem to be such a pleasant and sociable fellow.
I'm afraid the real hedonist has to be sometimes. I discovered ecstasy as a solitary pleasure, but it does not mean it can't ever be shared.
London's lone gourmet. What a strange title.
I used that name in my early years when I was a food critic, and I kept it.
I'm investigating the source of the epidemic in this district. Have you noticed anything unusual?
Not really. Wait, now that you mention it, I don't see the McPhersons in my favorite restaurants. They love delicate meals too, you understand.
Thank you. It may be nothing, but I'll investigate anyway.
No, lehet, hogy van, végre mondott egy jó...
In the southern part of the district.
Na, végre van egy nyom.
The railway bridge. There is a courtyard, if I remember rightly.
Jó.
Goodbye, Mr. Russell. I'm sure you'll take care of yourself.
Jó. Érd el a fertőzés második forrását. Több forrás is van. Aha, itt lent. Vénusszal kéne találkozni, most már tudok vele beszélni, mert már négyes izén van hipnózis jelen. Zárva.
Oh, ho, ho. Continue like this.
Maria, ez nem azaz, azaz, bocsánat.
Hello again, Venus.
Jonathan, you're still up. Can't you just knock at people's doors during the day?
Engedj be.
I'm sure you can spare me a few minutes. For old time's sake.
Of course you may enter, Jonathan. I remember when Mary came here with her husband and her son. It was...
Na, vakerolj nekem.
It's a pleasure to see you again, Venus.
So you returned from the war in one piece too. Thank God. My Clarence is back home too.
How is the old rascal?
Probably outside, chasing ghosts and chimeras. Clarence has changed a lot since he returned from the war, you know.
Jó. Mesélj, mi újság van itten? Hogy vagy az utolsó alkalom óta?
How have you been since the last time we met? How long has it been?
3 éve.
3 years now?
I've done my duty, like all British women. You have no idea what it was like to wait for months without knowing if I'd still be a wife or a widow.
I understand. Luckily, this part of town has been saved from the worst of the bombings, from what I've seen.
Yes, and it's also true about the epidemic. The flu has killed here too, of course, but not on such a large scale as in other parts of town.
Oh, te normális vagy. Környékről mesél.
Have you noticed anything peculiar about the neighborhood recently?
You mean except for your return to town? No. Oh, and again, Jonathan, please accept my condolences for your sister.
Spondját rá, és köszi.
Thank you, Venus. It was so sudden, and I've been so busy, I haven't spoken to anyone about it.
I wish I could have assisted at the funeral, but you know, it's been so quick. And what with the epidemic in the streets?
There's no need to apologize, my dear. It's normal, considering the circumstances.
No, it's not. I am sure that Clarence has not even thought to present you his condolences. He is too busy with his penny dreadful stories.
Miért olyan meglepő, hogy visszatértem?
Why is my return so surprising?
It's more an unexpected happy end than a surprise. You and Clarence, back from the war. You have no idea how hard it's been for me.
Mit tudsz a családod hírnevéről?
Venus, why do you worry so much about your family's reputation?
Everyone laughs at Clarence now. And they avoid me because they believe I share his insane opinions. I'm a leper in my own community.
Személyesek, a vámpirokkal való megszállottságáról mit tudsz Clarence-en?
Tell me about Clarence's obsession with vampires.
It drives me so crazy, it makes my stomach hurt. I was so relieved to have him back. I quickly realized he'd lost his mind in France.
I understand your irritation, Venus. But you have to accept the trauma Clarence endured on the battlefield.
The question is simple, Jonathan. Is my husband mad? Yes or no? Do vampires exist? Or is Clarence a lunatic?
So
you don't believe Clarence?
If poor Mary, bless her soul, had tried to convince you of the existence of bloody vampires, would you have believed her? Seriously?
És mit gondolsz róla?
The important question is, what do you really think of your husband?
I'm tough, Jonathan. He should have told me the horrors he witnessed, however appalling it was, instead of inventing a fantasy about blood-drinking monsters.
Jó, ezek megvoltak. Mit tudsz a fertőzések a második hullámról?
I'm investigating the source of the epidemic in this district. Have you noticed anything unusual?
The McPhersons. I heard they locked themselves in their own house.
They could just be afraid of getting sick.
Perhaps you're right. But if I were you, I'd pay them a visit.
Hol vannak?
A big house, reachable through a courtyard. To the north of the railway bridge.
Vasúti északra. Jó, megvan a következő nyom. Köszi, Vénuszkám.
Goodbye for now.
Jó. Nézzünk körbe a saját lakunkban.
I remember when Mary came here with her husband and her son. They were such a beautiful family.
Jó, még oda nem megyek föl. Nézzük, van-e itt valami Und du gehst bent. Oh. Oh, Gunja.
I'm so happy you're lost, Jonathan.
Jó, mint Arthur ott ragadt, hogy még mindig Mary gyászolja. Oké, megértettem, spondját rá. Jó, menjünk föl. Azt hittem volt itt valaki, ez csak egy állvány.
It's locked.
Oké. Vénusz naplója. 1918. július 9. Végig sírtam a tegnapi napot és éjszakát is. Örömkönnyek voltak. Nem tudtam, hogy a boldogság ilyen fájdalmas tud lenni. Épp most is nekem, az én Clarence-em élve és sértetlenül tért haza a háborúból. 2 hét múlva itthon lesz. Köszönöm neked, Istenem. Annyira köszönöm neked. Alig várom, hogy viszont lássam szeretett férjemet. 1918. augusztus 14. Clarence viselkedése aggodalommal tölt el. Visszatérésre óta nem ugyanaz az ember. Az első hetekben azt gondoltam, mindössze időre van szüksége, hogy visszarázódjon, de viselkedése egyre inkább kiszámíthatatlan. Mostanában éjjel-nappal odakint van, és bizonyítékokat keres, az influenza nem érdekli, én sem érdeklem. Kezd meg ijeszteni. 1918. szeptember 24-e. Nem tudom megérteni, Clarence a havi fizetése felét elverte arra, hogy valamiféle ostoba röpcédulákat nyomtathasson, amiket ingyen akar szétosztani a szomszédságban. Az emberek kezdenek kinevetni, most pedig valami nyilvános előadást kíván tartani egy nemrég bezárt színházi épületben, hogy felhívja az emberek figyelmét a Londonban élő gonosz teremtményekre. A belépés természetesen ingyenes, a férjem talán épségben tért haza a háborúba, de attól félek, hogy odaállt, elvesztette a józan ezét. 1918. szeptember 24. Clarence az e-mailben bevallotta, hogy nem csak fizetése felét, hanem a teljes munkabérét, sőt a megtakarításának egy részét is elköltötte. Azt mondta, hogy a háború miatt a papír és a festék is nagyon drága, de ezt az áldozatot meg kellett hozniuk. Eközben az emberek nyilvánosan is kigúnyolnak bennünket, nem tudom, mit tegyek. 1918. október 5. Mr. Galway a hentes a mai napon elküldte a havi számlát és kérte, hogy fizessem ki az egészet. Ezen kívül tudatta velem, hogy mostantól minden alkalommal pénzt akar látni, amikor húst veszünk nála. Több nem volt ráírva. 2 nappal ezelőtt ugyanezt mondta nekem a Pék is. Először ez csak egy újfajta megoldásnak tartottam a megszólításuk és a nyárvány miatt, de úgy tűnik, hogy a barátaim boltokkal kötött pénzügyi megállapodásait nem érintik. Annyira veszélyeltem magam. Meg se tudtam szólalni. 1918. október 8. Ez így nem mehet tovább. Clarence teljesen elvesztette a józan eszét. Az összes pénzünket elszór, és fogalmam sincs, hogyan akadályozhatnám meg ezt meg. Néha azt kívánom, bárcsak ne tért volna vissza háborúból. Necces, nagyon necces. Igen, a családi vagyonát a West Endi vámpírok elleni hadjáratának finanszírozására fordítja. És leszarja a feleségét. Oké. Okay. Aha. És akkor gondolom... Csukodjon már be az az ajtó, könyörgöm. Így lehet bejutni. Mondtam, be kell jutni Vénuszhoz, és így ezen keresztül tudok bemenni. Emilyhez.
That can't be a good sign.
Ez nem lehet jó jel.
No sign of a struggle. It seems Charlotte's friend knew the killer and let him in.
Oh, blood.
I should follow the trail.
Kövessük a nyomokat. A Emily szerelmes levele. 1918. november 5. Drága Jacques, mikor fogjuk végre látni egymást? Ma éjjel, holnap? Már alig várom, amióta azon a holdvényes éjszakán csókoloztunk a hídon. Szeretném újra érezni a fogaidat az ajkamon. Ez a gyönyörű fájdalom a nyakamnál, amikor megharaptál, te kis ördög. Szerintem vámpír volt. Ez végtelennek tűnő pillanatig azt hittem. Egy végtelennek tűnő pillanatig azt hittem, hogy abban a Milutonban azon az éjjel a hídon végzel velem. De nem. Szerelmetes zsakkom, te még mindig gyengéd jegyesen voltál, akit ismerek, és te csak évődtél velem. Alig várom, hogy végre ihassak a véredből, és azután halhatatlanként láthassam kedves barátnőmet, Charlotte-ot. Először csak játszanék vele, ahogy te mutattad, hogy kell játszani a halandókkal, de azután olyanná tenném őt, amilyenek mi vagyunk. Miénk lennének az éjszakák, és megszabadíthatnánk Londont a tisztázatlan lelkektől. Maradok odaadással feléd, Emily. Szerintem mindegyik megvámpírosodott.
Something must have gone wrong.
Someone
is responsible for this mess. But who?
Okay. Folytassuk a vért. Jó, most már nyitva van. Az északi dokkok. Egy skál. Ez falon túl van. Maga kérem.
Who are you? What are you doing?
I could ask
you the same question.
I'm the Marquis de Bois Colombe, and I strongly invite you to find your own game, sir.
I'm not here to sustain myself. I'm currently investigating the death of a young woman killed by a vampire.
A young woman killed by a vampire? Oh, you're joking, right? Oh, I do love the British sense of humor.
Azt tudom, hogy te vagy Emily Pasia, de ki vagy te valójában?
Exactly
meg hogy Ekon vámpír vagy.
Jacques Michel Guillaume Florimond, de Marquis de Bois Colombe, at your service, my dear cousin.
You're French, but your English is quite good.
I was born in France, sir, but I consider myself a traveler of this world. So many countries, so many tantalizing tastes.
Ugyanolyan orra van, mint nekem. Mint hogy egy alternatív modell lenne. Kuzin. Tanárokonok vagyunk? Vagy ő te is Ekon vagy, úgy érted?
Are we related?
We could be of the same blood, my dear. I tend to consider all Ekons as family, don't you?
Nagyon ismerős a hangja egyébként.
What are you doing here?
I recently decided to visit London. I've always dreamed of visiting a city on the verge of collapse. Such a delicate, yet intense spectacle.
You take pleasure from others' misery.
I have been a totally depraved and immoral creature since the day I was reborn, sir. And probably before.
What do you plan to do here?
Take pleasure. Take pictures. Enjoy the show. Have fun. Believe me, I won't be the only foreign immortal who bought a ticket to the fair.
I followed the trail of blood from her room to here.
Oh, you're referring to that young woman. Yes, the meeting turned messy. I'm afraid I ruined my last redingot.
So you admit you murdered her?
I admit nothing, my good sir. I only regret the blood of that girl staining my clothes. Oh, blood can be so messy.
What happened?
She wanted to become one of us. Not the first time I have received such a proposal, but I must admit her direct approach tempted me.
And then what?
The body rejected my blood. It happens, you know, sometimes even with voluntary prey. At least her gurglings brought me some fun. Until the artery burst.
Szóval te ölted meg. Öh. that my girl had them? That he's a
I believe you, sir. Emily's diary confirms.
Mert szerettétek egymást azért.
Emily was her name.
De nem is tudtad a nevét.
Well, mystery solved then.
Yes, I suppose so. You can go.
And so can you. Farewell, sir.
Nem szabad meg, nem szabad megölni, mert akkor buktam a perfect végét. Hát nem kaptam nyomot. De ő nem volt izé. És akkor ezzel csináltam egy shortcutot, és akkor most innen a dokkokból át tudok menni a dokkokba. Akció van. De miért jöttek erre? Töltödött vissza.
Good evening, Miss.
And good evening to you, Dr. Reed.
I have found out what happened to your friend, Emily.
I can handle the truth. There's no need to hide the bloody details.
Your friend was planning to become a vampire. She thought she'd met an honest one and made a deal with him. Unfortunately, Emily did not survive the process.
My mother told me many times about the risks of being turned. I often suspected she exaggerated the danger to avoid me being tempted.
No. The risk is real. Have you any idea what a body has to endure to become an organism entirely consumed by its need to process and recombine blood?
I should never have talked to Emily about vampires. I never thought she'd actually try it without me. Thank you, sir. Here, take this for your discretion.
Charlotte szöveke. Ez egy legendary!
Why do you still hope to become a vampire in spite of your mother's refusal?
It's the immortal aspect of vampires that interests me. The world won't improve unless women take charge. I'm convinced of that.
You're obviously a clever woman with a good education and a brilliant future. But have you thought about the price you'd have to pay? The loneliness, the necessary masquerade.
Is it not true of every high position? To change this world and make it a better place, one needs time on one side.
Hú, minden titok feloldódott nála. Igen, Charlotte azt reméli, hogy hatékonyabban folytathatja az igazságtalanság elleni küzdelmet, miután halhatatlanná válik. Aha, ez volt. Minden. Mindent tudunk róla.
Your mother has refused to turn you into a vampire. Tell me more about it.
Each time we argue, Mother expresses the same fear. She wants me to remain alive and full of joy, rather than become melancholy and immortal. She claims you can't have one without the other. It's pure selfishness.
It's your mother's choice. As daughters and sons, we have to accept the decisions our parents make for us, despite our own wishes.
I love my mother, and have accepted everything from her. Even that she named me Charlotte, when it was not my original name.
Does it bother you?
No. Whoever I was when I was born, I am now Charlotte Ashbury. It hurts as much as it makes me proud to know that's the name my mother will read on my tombstone.
Your mother has walked this earth for much longer than you or I. She is wise, and we should not ignore her advice when we disagree with it.
But why shouldn't I be allowed to forge my own experience? There can't be only one righteous way to deal with eternity.
Tell me, Charlotte, how do you plan to achieve eternal life, since you've obviously given it a lot of thought?
I won't give up. You have no idea how determined I am, sir. I may contract a deadly disease. I may throw myself under a carriage, just to be saved by her sweet kiss.
That's a disturbing answer, young lady. And the worst part of it is, I know you speak the truth.
There are less dangerous ways, Doctor. Instead of throwing myself under a horse like Emily Davison, I could just throw myself into your arms.
Be careful what you wish for, young lady. I could gaze at you right now and then take you to a shady corner and have my way with you. And leave your carcass to the rats.
You wouldn't dare. My mother would know. She'd never forgive you.
How could she suspect me? Do you know how many vampires are lurking in the city tonight as we speak?
Das musst du direkt verhindern.
Have a worse sense of humor than mine.
Oh, my God. For one second, I thought you actually... Excellent, Dr. Reed. Very convincing.
Goodbye, Charlotte.
She's been quite busy.